shtick. This guy have a good shtick. The best shtick in Melbourne. Right?
What is this that I'm stirring?
Come on, not taking the refusal lightly, decided he must destroy Mordechai's people.
I'll put so many owls in them, they'll look like a waterbed with owls.
But it seemed that Mordechai, or Mordi, as the Don called him, overheard Haman. So once more, he warns Esther to warn the Don.
Warn the Don.
Tell your people not to eat for 3 days.
What does not eating have to do with anything?
Which reminds me, I haven't eaten all day. Anyway, where was I? Oh yes, Mordi still refused to kiss Haman's ring, which really boiled him up, so Haman decides he needs to get rid of him.
We need to get rid of Mordechai.
Meanwhile, back at the safe house, the Don remembers that he still owes Mordechai a favor. He calls in Haman and asks him what he should do to honor his savior. Haman, thinking that the Don is talking about him, says,
make him a made man. A wise guy, if you will.
So be it. Yeah, I want you to go to this Mordechai. I call him Naughty Morty. And I want you to tell him that he's a made man. An honorary wise guy.
Haman wasn't too thrilled about this sudden turn of events. And as he tells Morty the news, Esper whispers to the Don Haman's plan to kill Mordechai. Angry, the Don orders Haman to be hung by his ears. I know, it's weird, but that was the style back then. Crazy, right? Anyway, at the same time, the Don repays Mordi by making him his right-hand, left-handed man. And his job?
Make sure everything stays prim around here. Know what I mean?
Well, we're back. It's the last segment of the show. And who have we got with us? But Henry, and it's good to see you again. I haven't seen you for quite a while. I'm glad to see that you're not wearing any more stupid hats.
I'm very colourful today.
Yeah, you really?
I think there are two things about Purim that I really like, and one is the colour, and the other one is the movement and all the different characters. You know, there's colour and movement all the time in Purim.
Yeah, but we don't have to make a Guns and Magilla out of the whole thing.
Well, I'm doing
them.
We do.
Make a Guns and Magilla?
We do, always.
The whole Guns and Magilla.
And that is?
The whole story.
Yes, but we use that as a term, even though it's a term that refers to Purim, obviously Guns and Magilla. But it's a term we use metaphorically for many overdo other things. You know, when you go to too much
Just make a small dinner, not a Guns and Magilla.
You know, the whole big...
Instead of saying to cut a story short, it's the opposite of that.
Yes.
You're expanding on it.
That's right.
So, yes.
And we don't want any of that now.
Guns and Magilla means the entire story of
Which is what we're doing right now.
We're just going on and on.
Anyway, Henry, what have you got to tell us?
The most exciting news the Shtick has is that we are getting a new time slot.
No, really?
I think that's fabulous.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
As of Sunday, the 7th of March.
7th, yep.
Yeah, we are going to be on a Sunday new time slot.
I think we're taking over Rove's time slot.
Yes, we are.
We are 9 o'clock.
Direct competition with Rove.
He's off air now.
Good. Oh, is he off air, is he?
He's off, yeah.
Oh, really? He's not.
So
I'm so behind.
This is the new roving shtick.
But the other time slots remain the same.
Yes, they all stay the same. Wednesday, 2:30. Friday, 3 a.m.
We cater for old people, insomniacs, mental cases.
Yeah. You want to know something? If I'm up at 2:30 in the morning, I think I know what I'm going to be doing with myself. Anyway.
Really?
Yeah. Watch the shtick.
I reckon that's
yes,
what
exactly.
Doing, yeah.
Watch the shtick.
And it's been great to have Eddie on the show too. Whatever guise he's in, he's always terrific to see as a personality rather than the regular Eddie that we know.
Yeah.
How much did he pay you to say that?
He didn't pay me. I just got a couple of free tickets to the cinema in Belgrave.
He's getting kickbacks. Not getting any.
No, we're not allowed to get kickbacks. Yeah,
he's making a Guns and Magilla. Okay.
Kicked in the ass.
Any more?
Go ahead.
Our end music is also back to front and upside down, because we haven't mentioned that Purim is all about being completely opposite. Well, I'm dressed bright and colourful, which is not very unusual for me.
That's correct.
But I'm going back to myself. But there are two guys that are on in Melbourne. Avram Fried and Yehuda Glantz. And if you remember, we had Yehuda Glantz. You remember him? They're doing a show tonight, and I'm going to film them. And hopefully I'll have some footage to insert at the end of the show. Mm-hmm. And more hopefully, I hope that they do a song together so I can get them both together, because I'm not sure what I'm going to use at this stage. But until next week, when we're on a new time slot.
Yeah, that's great. Look forward to it.
It's goodbye for us. I won't be here next week. I'll be travelling yet again. I'm just a traveller.
Adam will be back.
He's a wandering salesman. He's a wanderer.
Bye-bye.
Bye.